When you clear a dungeon with no form of EXP gain, you get the following EXP bonuses. You get dungeon clear bonus, rank bonus, and contest bonus. Dungeon clear bonus is if you cleared a dungeon. You must be alive when the dungeon is clear to get this bonus. This bonus is always 30%. Rank bonus is determined by your hit damage, combo, technique, and shot damage ranks. Hit damage is how much damage you dealt in the dungeon, combo is based on how long your longest combo in the dungeon was, and shot damage was how much you were hit. The less you get hit, the higher your rank will be. I believe rank bonus ranges from 0% to 18%. 0% occurs if you get F in all the categories. I believe the contest bonus is how well you do in comparison to your teammates. MVP always gets 10%. If you solo a dungeon or duo solo dungeon, you will always get a 10% contest bonus. Contest bonus ranges from 0 to 10%. You can get 0% if you barely contribute any damage to the run or do no damage at all. All of these bonuses together, I will refer to as your bonus multiplier. The EXP you get when you clear a dungeon with no form of EXP gain with the bonus multipliers, I will refer to as clear EXP. Since Elsword automatically gives you clear EXP when you clear a dungeon, to truly find out how much EXP you get from a dungeon with literally no forms of EXP boost, you need to divide the clear EXP by the bonus multipliers. This number I will refer to as base EXP. So your base EXP is equal to your clear EXP divided by your bonus multiplier. The table on the screen right now shows data I have collected that shows the base EXP for the Void Dungeon should be around 1,258,230. The next table on the screen right now shows data I have collected that shows the base EXP for 13.5 should be around 11,877,600. Based off the data from the tables shown previously, I strongly believe that bonus multiplier is dungeon clear bonus plus rank bonus plus contest bonus, and also the base EXP of a dungeon can be found by dividing the clear EXP by the bonus multiplier. Understanding how the base EXP of a dungeon is determined is very important for calculating how other EXP boosts work. So there are six types of EXP boosts in Elsword, besides the bonus multipliers. First is tab EXP. This is the EXP gain shown when you pull up your stats tab. So if you press U, you press the magnifying glass, the number that's listed here is your tab EXP, or what I'll refer to as your tab EXP. Things that contribute to tab EXP include titles, socketed EXP gain, pet gem of skills, mystic stone sockets, ERP, promotional costumes, skill cut-ins and awakenings, synergy, and the 5th anniversary crown. The second type of EXP boost in Elsword are your EXP medals. Third is the guild EXP boost. Fourth is house buff or the hot spring buff. Fifth is EXP contracts or the guild EXP contracts. And sixth are random missions. Each of these are calculated differently into the final EXP you get from a dungeon, so it is important to know the different types. Also, an important thing I want to bring up is that certain dungeons in Elsword will have special mobs that will give you times to the normal amount of EXP when you defeat them than normal. For this guide, I chose the Void Dungeon 13.5 and 11.5 because they do not have a chance of having these special mobs. Special mobs will be indicated like the one on the screen right now. So the first type of EXP I want to talk about is Tab EXP. So tab EXP is calculated using the equation above. So you multiply your base EXP by your bonus multiplier, and then you multiply that by 1 plus your tab EXP. So for example, if your base EXP is 1,258,230 and your bonus multiplier is 43 and your tab EXP is 546.7, then you would plug in the numbers like this into the equation. And on the screen right now is a data table that shows why I strongly believe tab EXP is calculated in this manner. So on the left side, you'll see the calculated final EXP. This is the amount of EXP I get when I plug the numbers into the equation. And then the actual final EXP is the amount of EXP I got when I actually cleared a dungeon with those types of EXP boosts. So next I want to talk about EXP medals. So EXP medals are calculated with the equation on the screen right now. So basically, you add the EXP medal to your bonus multiplier, and then you multiply that with the base EXP. So for example, if your base EXP is 1,258,230, and your bonus multiplier is 43%, and you have an EXP medal that gives you 100% EXP boost, you would plug in the numbers the way it's shown on the screen right now. And then the data tables on the screen right now show why I strongly believe EXP medals are calculated in this manner. Alright, moving on, I want to talk about guild EXP. Guild EXP is calculated using the equation on the screen right now. So basically, you multiply your base EXP by your bonus multiplier, and then you multiply that by 1 plus your guild EXP. So for example, if your base EXP is 1,258,230 and your bonus multiplier is 43 and your guild EXP is 15, then you would plug in the numbers the way it's shown on the screen right now. And then the data table on the screen right now shows why I strongly believe guild EXP is calculated in this manner. So next I want to talk about the house buff or the hot spring buff. The house buff and the hot spring buff are calculated in the same manner, so I'm going to refer to both simply as house EXP. So house EXP is calculated using the equation on the screen right now. So if your base EXP is 1,258,230 and your bonus multiplier is 43 and your house EXP is 35, you would plug in the numbers into the equation as shown on the screen right now. And the data tables shown on the screen right now are why I strongly believe house EXP is calculated in this manner. Moving on, let's talk about EXP contracts. So EXP contracts are calculated using the equation shown on the screen right now. So if your base EXP is 197,959 and your bonus multiplier is 44% and you have an EXP contract up, you would plug in the numbers in the way shown on the screen right now. The data table shown on the screen right now shows why I strongly believe EXP contracts are calculated in this manner. And finally, for how everything is calculated together, you would use the equation shown on the screen right now. So you would add your EXP metal, house EXP, and EXP contract to your bonus multiplier, and then you would multiply that with your base EXP, and then you would add your guild EXP, EXP contract, and tab EXP to 1, and then you would multiply that with everything before. So if your base EXP was 197,959 and your bonus multiplier is 48 and your EXP contract is 50% and your tab EXP was 478.7% and you had a 100% EXP metal and your guild EXP is 15% and your house EXP buff was 35% and you had an EXP contract up, you would plug in the numbers in the way that's shown on the screen right now. And once again, the data table on the screen right now shows why I strongly believe everything is calculated like this. And finally, I want to talk about random missions. So random missions are calculated using the equation on the screen right now. So if your base EXP is 197,959 and your bonus multiplier is 44% and you had a random mission of 170%, you would plug in the numbers in the way that's shown on the screen right now. And if you were curious, random missions are calculated with everything else using the equation on the screen right now. Alright, and to wrap up this video, linked in the description is a Google spreadsheet you could use to calculate how much EXP you would get from any dungeon in Elsword. You can make a copy of this spreadsheet and plug in the appropriate information. Do remember, as mentioned earlier in the video, that because of special mobs, your numbers will be slightly off for dungeons where special mobs can spawn. Also, I currently don't have any data for 11.3. I also do not include any dungeons before 11x and dungeons where EXP gain is hardly relevant in this Google spreadsheet. But you can still apply the formulas to those dungeons as well if you are interested.